Hello friends, now I am discussing about architecture of Gopuram. So Gopuram is a part of temple as the gate of every temple in South India is called Gopuram. Remember this line. Gopuram means the gate or the entrance of the South Indian temple. Gopuram is usually having a special place in southern temples, and due to the encouragement of the Pandya rulers in India, in southern part, these special kind of the characteristics of the temples have been constructed. They built high outer wall and beautifully decorated gates. I'm talking about the gates, how they are look, big and wider outer wall with beautifully decorated gates outside the surrounding part of the temples. The gates of these temples are known as Gopurams. In a one line answer, the exact answer is entrance of the South Indian temple is called Gopuram. Or the Gopuram means the entrance of the temple. This is a one line answer. An explanation as I have given, you can write down. The glory of the Gopuram is found in usually in so many places where we can see in Meenakshi Mandir, the Meenakshi temple of South India in Madurai, then Kanchi temple, we can find also such a great Gopurams. Thereafter, the Gopurams of the Brihadeshwara temple is also well known. So remember one thing, that Gopuram is special part of the temple to remember and to accept it. Right, my friends? So understand it as the special character of the South Indian temple. Right? Now I want to discuss that how many Gopurams and how much lengthy Gopurams are in Indian South Indian temple. Basically, as I have understood, that every Gopurams are having multi-storied gate with some heighted structure. So Gopurams in India is having special place of Indian architectural study. As I have told, which temples have the Gopuram, I have discussed. Brihadeshwara temple has 13-storied Gopuram. I have said the multi-storied, so 13-storied Gopuram. One story is having the height of 10 feet. So now you think that how much height of a door, then what could be the height of the temple? You understand this. So remember that this is a special kind of the temples. Okay. Second point you have to remember that after the Brihadeshwara, another one is, as I have said, Meenakshi temple. It has also a huge Gopuram. Four main Gopurams in Meenakshi temple you can find. Also, I said about the Kanchi. In Kanchi also the temple has the biggest Gopurams also. So remember, in India, Kanchi, Madurai and Thanjavur, the Brihadeshwara temple. These are important places where the Gopurams are found, and all these Gopurams are very well known to remember. Okay, my friends. So now I want to discuss some other details of other important temples in India. The other temple is a Khajuraho temple. Basically, Khajuraho temple is temple built in time of Chandel dynasty. So they are called Chandel rulers. Chandel rulers of Bundelkhand had constructed these temples, and actually 80 temples were there, but now 25 temples are exist, and you will be surprised to know all the temples are having extraordinary kind of minute carving and designs on temple outside and inside also. So these temples are very well known to remember. Now Khajuraho temples are place for the people to visit, and people are visiting there optimistically, even coming from the outsider, foreigners, and visiting this place for understanding the precious carvings of it. Today it is a place of visit for lots of the foreigners to India, right? Now I want to discuss about Jain temples. Jain temples are also called Derasar, and as like the other temples, in Jain temples also the Garbhagriha is there, but here in Jain temples the word Garbhagriha is not used, but the word used is Gabharu. Gabharu, G-A-B-H-A-R-O, Gabharu is the word used for Jain temples where the idols of different Tirthankaras have been placed. Now, well-known Jain temples I want to discuss are Vaibhara temple at Rajgrih, Vipulachal, Ratnagiri, Udaygiri, Khandagiri, Shramagiri. Usually these are the five main Jain temples in northern India, as well as with the Samet Shikhar. We all know this is the biggest pilgrim place in all over the India for the Jains, situated in Bihar. Thereafter, you remember one point, that the Samet Shikhar is also known as a Madhuvana. So in India, as like the other religious temples, the Jain religious temples are also well known to understand. Now Adinath Bhagwan and other 20 Tirthankaras, actually there are 24 Tirthankaras, the religious preachers and the religious spreaders in all over the world for the Jainism is called Tirthankaras. These all people have spent their last days at this place. So the word is used in your book is Adinath Bhagwan and other 20 Tirthankaras attained Nirvanam, means the last days. They died at this place. For the Jains, the word is used Nirvana, means moksha, means salvation. So this place in Samet Shikhar is most important and valuable for the Jains. There are temples of Abhinandan Nathji and Parshvanathji in Bihar. Also Bhagwan Mahavir reached at the Samet Shikhar and spent their days here. दे ऑल्सो अटेंड सेल्वेशन और द मोक्ष इन समेत शिखर. सो दिस प्लेस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑल जैन पीपल. देर इज अ जैन टेम्पल एट पालीताना इन गुजरात एंड शंखेश्वरा नियर पंचासरा इन गुजरात. सो बोथ द प्लेसेस पालीताना एंड पंचासरा आर बोथ द प्लेसेस आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द एवरी जैन. सो जैन टेम्पल्स इन इंडिया, इन गुजरात, इन बिहार, देर आफ्टर द मोस्ट प्रेशियस इज दिलवाड़ा इन माउंट आबू. एंड मैनी जैन्स आर इवन टूडे वॉन्ट टू विजिट देयर एंड एवरी पीपल हु आर आर्ट लवर्स आर रेग्यूलरली गोइंग देयर टू सी द आर्ट. देर आर सो मैनी प्रेशियस आइडोल्स हैव बीन कर्व्ड एंड प्लेस्ड इन एवरी इंच एवरी सेंटीमीटर इन दिलवाड़ा जैन टेम्पल. सो द वन लाइन आई हैव रीड दैट इट इज एनग्रेव्ड पोएम ऑन मार्बल. सो दिस वर्ड इज शोइंग इट्स ब्यूटी. एनग्रेव्ड पोएम ऑन मार्बल द वर्ड इज यूज्ड इन दिस टेम्पल्स. सो नाउ यू अंडरस्टैंड इन इंडिया आबू माउंट आबू और द दिलवाड़ा इज स्पेशल प्लेस फॉर जैन्स. नाउ द वन स्टोरी इज देयर अबाउट दिस दिलवाड़ा टेम्पल. एक्चुअली देयर वॉज अ संघ पास ऑन बाय वस्तुपाल एंड थे इट वॉज प्रमोटेड बाय वस्तुपाल एंड थे पल गोइंग टू समेच्छिखर. बट एट द प्लेस ऑफ दिलवाड़ा दे स्टेड एंड दे हैड इनफ मनी ज्वेल्स गोल्ड. सो इट वॉज डिफिकल्ट टू कैरी विथ देम अप टू द बिहार समेच्छिखर. सो दे डिसाइडेड टू डिग एट देयर एंड पुट सम साइन. But as they started to dig the land, they got another assets, precious stones, diamond, jewels. It means they had lots of the wealth which they used to construct extraordinary temples in Dilwara. And so these Dilwara temples are considered as world famous carving, artistic skill and sculpture point of view to be studied. This is importance of Dilwara temple. So Dilwara temple became the extraordinary place. Okay, here which temples are found? Vimal Shah promoted and the Vimal Vasahi was constructed the place. The second place is on the name of Vastupal. It is called Lun Vasai. Lun Vasai, Khashir Vasai, Parshunath Temple, Vimal Vasai. These actually there are five temples combined or the complex of the five temples in Dilwara. Okay, except the Dilwara, another Jain temple is at Ranakpur in Rajasthan. So now you understand Dilwara, Ranakpur, Panchasara in Palitana, thereafter Samedshikhar. These are all important places for Jains. Okay, we have already understood about the Rajagiri, Udaygiri, Khandagiri, right? These all are the places where the Jain temples are even today found. And people are visiting there. So the art is shown is memorable, wonderful, artistic for explanation of Jain artistic religious contribution to the sculpture, art and construction. Okay, here I discussed about temples. Now we are going to understand about सन टेम्पल मोढेरा. सो मोढेरा इज अ सन टेम्पल, मीन्स इट इज अ टेम्पल फॉर द प्रेइंग ऑफ लॉर्ड सन. इट इज कंस्ट्रक्टेड बाय भीमदेव ऑफ सोलंकी डायनेस्टी. भीमदेव फर्स्ट, हिज नेम वॉज भीमदेव फर्स्ट, एंड इट वॉज बिल्ट इन 1026 एडी नियर मोढेरा विलेज इन मेहसाना डिस्ट्रिक्ट. इन दिस टेम्पल अ जेम वॉज स्टडेड इन द फोरहेड ऑफ आइडल ऑफ गॉड सन, इन द क्राउन ऑफ गॉड सन. बट नाउ दैट आइडल इज नॉट फाउंड एट द एंट्री गेट ऑफ दिस टेम्पल इज ऑलवेज फ्रॉम ईस्टर्न साइड. सो द फर्स्ट रे ऑफ द सन इज ऑलवेज कम इन डेली मॉर्निंग टू दैट प्लेस, एंड ड्यू टू दैट इट इज सेड, इट इज रिटन दैट द होल एरिया वॉज बींग कंप्लीटली एनलाइटन बाय द रिफ्लेक्शन फ्रॉम दैट जेम, एंड पीपल had enjoying its beauty of light. But now, as I have said, that idol is not found, so it is a matter of story only. Now we understand that this temple had also one pond near its campus. This pond had 108 small temples surrounding it, and in the days of different festivals, on the top of these small temples, different lamps are being placed and make it pleasant, beautiful look. So remember that the place of sun temple of Moढेरा is become place of the extraordinary look. In outer part of the garbhagrih of Moढेरा sun temple, there were 12 different shape and poses having idols of the sun was also placed, and even today all these 12 different idols are being found, but the main idol which I have said is not found there. So it is a part of the story only, but the main thing is this Moढेरा sun temple is a example of only one Iranian style of architecture in Gujarat. Remember, this is only single architectural place of Gujarat which is in the Iranian style, and the people are visiting there and they are seeing it and enjoying its beauty. Okay, I want to say one thing more. This place is also included in our government of India's archaeological survey maintaining and controlling part. So as the at least 5000 monuments in India are being managed, maintained and controlled and supervised by archaeological survey of India, the same way this temple is also under supervision and monitoring of Archaeological Survey of India. That is great matter of proud for us, and also all over the world people are coming there. Okay, one thing more I want to discuss. At there, wherever you can go, you can find some museum. In that museum, from that nearby area, which idols, some heads of the idols have been found and placed with explanation of that detail. And people can visit these museums to understand the remains whichever has been placed, and it is giving us detail of our Indian culture, so it is matter of proud for all of us, right my friends? So understand this, these are detail which we discussed today about Sun Temple, Chariot Temples and other temples in India, right my friends? So you prepare all the topics of temple architecture in India. Okay, my friends.